Good afternoon, students. I welcome you for another important session, revision lecture, as well as quiz students, question answer sessions. You are going to get 1 to 2 minutes for answering every question. These are objective type questions, students. And the main purpose of this is, guys, that you will learn a lot of science. You will learn the chapter thoroughly by answering these questions. Your last performance was 100 out of 100. So that was a great score. I hope you are keeping up the score all the time. And before I begin the session, something about the topic which we are having today, what we are working today, gravitation. Students, you are aware, you know what is a gravitation, student. What is gravitation? And who was the scientist who gave the laws of gravitation? Can you tell me, students? Who was the scientist who has given the laws of gravitation? You are aware of that? Fast 30 seconds. Do you know the name of the scientist on whose work is gravitation, students? Laws of gravitation given by whom? Fast answer the questions. You are already aware of that? Newton's law of gravitation, you are aware, students, you know about it.
Sir Isaac Newton.
Yes. Okay. You are aware, students. Isaac Newton. Okay. So, very important thing was that the Newton's law of gravitation are very important, student. Newton's law of gravitation. What we observe, student, what you know already, moon is orbiting around the earth. Tell me, orbiting around the earth?
Yes, sir.
Okay, keep on interacting with me, keep on answering the question. This is very important to keep our energy high, students. Energy level should not drop. This is very, very important. And you know, the planets are orbiting around. Planets orbit around
Sun.
Okay. What is the reason for this? Why will moon be orbiting around the earth and planets orbiting around the sun, student? What is the force? What is the force, student, which is causing this? Tell me, what is this known as? Center seeking, what is that force? What we told you? Centripetal force, student. Why the centripetal force exists, student? Because of the gravitational pull. Because of the force of gravity, students. Therefore, students, you know, when objects are thrown upward, they come back, student, they fall back. Why they come back? Because of the, tell me, gravitational force of the earth. What is the universal law of gravitation, students? What is the universal law of gravitation, students?
Sir, the law of gravitation states that the force of attraction between any two objects is proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them.
Excellent answer has been given by Vidhi. Perfect answer, absolutely right answer. And what is the mathematical formula for that, student? We write G M into M divided by, students, d square. So these are the masses of the objects, and d is the distance between the center of the object, students. What is this g, students? Capital G. This is known as, what is g, students? What is the g known as? Gravitational, universal gravitational constant. Universal gravitational constant. And what will it be equal to, students? If m is 1, if m is 1 and d is 1 unit, student, then what will happen? What will be the result of this? Then force will be equal to, force will be equal to the universal gravitational constant. So that is the force which is exerted when the masses are unit masses, and the distance between the unit masses is also 1 unit, students. Therefore, if I take kilogram, kilogram, meter square, what is the value of the g, students? Can you tell me what is the value of the g and what are the units of g, students? What are the units and value of the g?
So g is 6.674 into 10 minus 11 power.
6.67 into 10 power
minus 11.
Minus 11 units. The units have been asked many times in the paper, student. Units of g. Newton. You can calculate the units from here. The g is equal to f into d the square divided by m into m. F is Newton, student. Meter square, and kilogram into kilogram minus 2. So Newton, meter square, kilogram minus 2. Therefore, you have seen, students, the value of g is a constant. It does not depend on mass of any object. As you can see, unit masses and also distance is unit, student. Therefore, we will use this value for solving the question, students. It is a universal constant. Universal constant. Then we discuss the free fall. What is the free fall of the object, students? When objects are falling towards the earth, they experience an acceleration, which is called acceleration due to gravity. What do we call this? Small g, students. And what is the small g, students? What is the value of small g? You know, f is equal to m into a. Acceleration will be replaced by m into g, student, and that is equal to g m into m by d the square, students. Therefore, this mass of the object will cancel, and you can say g is equal to gravitational constant m and d the square. For earth, student, for objects which are very near to earth, d is taken as what? The radius of the earth. This is the radius of the earth, student. Then what it become? G is equal to g, capital G, mass of the earth divided by the radius of the earth. Clear? Am I writing correct?
Yes, sir.
So by this way, we can calculate the value. Mass of earth is known, radius of earth is known. We can calculate the value of g. What is the value of the g, students? The value of g comes out to be 9.8 meter per second square. So if we keep the values of for the earth, student, we can calculate the value of g. And the students, will the value be same on the moon or it will be different? Tell me, what will be the value of g, will it be same or different, student? Mass of the earth, radius of the earth, what will we use, student? There, mass of the moon and radius of the moon, right? So we can calculate the value of g, acceleration due to gravity depends on mass and radius, but it does not depend on the mass of the object, students. So further we define, student, difference between mass and weight, student. What is the difference between mass and weight? Will your mass change if you go to moon, or it will remain the same, students? Mass changes or remains same? Mass.
So it remains same.
Sir, it remains same.
Same. And weight is given by, weight is a force with which you are attracted towards the earth, m into g. So what will happen to your weight, student, if you go to the moon? Your weight on moon, will it be same as your weight on earth?
No, sir, it will be different.
It will be different. So if we substitute those values in the formula which we have indicated, students, you will find that the weight of on the moon and earth is 1/6, student, 1/6. So weight of an object on moon divided by weight of an object on earth is 1/6, student, 1/6. That means the weight of the moon will become 1/6, student. We already did that. Okay, then we told you something about, student, pressure or thrust, student. What is pressure, students? What is pressure?
Pressure is the it is the thrust or force per unit area on a surface.
That is the correct answer. Vidhi, your answer correct. Thank you very much. You people are so great. You know everything. What will be the SI unit of the pressure, students? What will be the SI unit of pressure? SI unit of pressure.
Sir, Pascal, PA.
What we say? Force, Newton, meter square. So we can see that pressure has Newton per meter square, students, and you are aware of this, that why camel can run, student? Camel can run on desert, student, easily. What is the reason? What is the reason, students?
Sir, because they have wide feet which help them to balance their weight on loose sand.
What do you see? Army tanks, they have belt, student, not the wheels. So cutting tools have sharp edges. Have sharp edges, students. The reason is pressure is force per unit area. The feet of the camel, you see, are like that. It has very long feet, student. So the area, when the area will become more, student, pressure will be less. Pressure is inversely proportional to area, students. So the area of contact is decreased. Same is the reason why we don't have the wheels, but you have belt, student, of the tank, because the weight of the tank, you know, is 1,000 tons, more than 1,000 tons. This is more than 1,000 ton, student. Otherwise, it will just put very large pressure on the ground student. So pressure is decreased when the area is increased. These are the reasons, students. Another important thing we told you, do the fluids have pressure? Do the fluids have pressure, students? Liquids. Liquids and gases are fluids, students. Do they have pressure? Yes, liquids and fluids, you know, both liquids and gases, student. They also have exerted pressure. You know about it. And what is buoyancy, student? What is buoyancy? What is buoyancy, student? How do you swim on water, students? In a swimming pool, you are swimming, you are floating on the water, students. Why you are not sinking in the water, students? So what is happening? There is a buoyant force, student, upward thrust, students, which is experienced because the liquids also have pressure, students. So that is what we say, that the water also has a pressure, student. The liquids have pressure, so you can easily swim. And certain objects can float on water, whereas certain objects sink, student, in water. What is the reason? Which objects will sink, students, and which objects will float on water? Tell me. You, what is a cork floats on water, but an iron needle sinks in water. Ship floats, but an iron needle sinks. What is the reason, students?
Sir, due to density.
Yes. If the density of the object is less than water, it will float. If the density of the object is more, it will sink. Students, we already did that, and we also told you what is the density, student. Density is mass by volume. So if we increase the volume, density will become less, student. Then the object can float. Then the principle which is used for the laws of flotation, can you name the principle, students? What happens if you put an object inside the water, it appears, its weight appears to be decreased, students. Why it is happening? Due to the force of buoyancy. And the liquid, if a liquid is completely filled, if you immerse a object or a solid in it, what happens? The liquid is displaced. Which law is that, student, which was used? Tell me the law.
The law of flotation.
Archimedes' principle. What is Archimedes' principle, student? What is Archimedes' principle, student? What it says, states? What it says, students? What it says, students? Archimedes' principle. What it
says? Sir, it states that a body immersed in a liquid loses weight by an amount equal to the weight of the liquid displaced.
That is correct answer. That is why you can see the ships are floating, students. Ships are floating, and designing of the ships, submarines, and all this, we are applying the Archimedes' principle, students. So objects having less density than that of the liquid in which they are immersed float on the surface. If density is more than the density of the liquid, then the object sinks, students. So all the objects will experience a force of buoyancy when they are immersed in a liquid. So here we have given you some complete revision. of the chapter of gravitation. Students, I would say, are we ready for the quiz, students? Tell me now.
Yes,
tell me.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
All right. You have energy? Timer. I have a timer here. Stop clock. I have a stopwatch here, student. Stopwatch. So you will get time. Student, the time, 1 minute answer time is there for you. And till now, you have scored 100 out of 100. Now we have to see how much you score. Guys, in this, that will indicate how much chapter you are learning. And you are going to be on top of the world by answering all these questions. I'm saying top of the world. You will be able to answer all the questions, students. All right, students. So here on the screen, students, first question is on the screen for you, students. A body of mass 1 kg, a body of mass 1 kg is attracted by Earth with the force which is equal to. You have four choices. 9.8 Newton, 6.6 into 10 power 11, C1 Newton, 9.8 meter per second. Student, what is your correct answer? What is your correct answer?
Sir, A part, 9.8 Newton.
Anya, what is your answer? What is your answer, Anya? A part is the correct answer, student. You have given answer so fast. What is the force? M into G. What is this 1 kg, student? Into 9.8 meter per second square, which is 9.8 newtons. Absolutely right answer given by Vidhi. Next question on the screen, student, you could answer the question so fast. Okay. What is the gravitational force between two objects? Attractive at large distances only, attractive at small distances only, attractive at all distances, attractive at distances, but repulsive at small distances. Students, what is your answer, student?
The C part, attractive at all distances.
C part?
Yes, sir.
All right. You already have seen the law of gravitation. You, both of you, correct answer. Correct answer in a very short period of time. This is an attractive force. Gravitational force is an attractive force, student. It is an attractive force. Okay. Very good answer. Next question is on the screen, students. The value of G increases as we go above the Earth's surface, decreases as we go to the center of the Earth, remains constant, is more at equator and less at the poles, students.
Sir, B part, decreases as we go to the center of the Earth.
Decreases as we go to the center of the Earth. The value of G increases as we go above the Earth surface. What is the formula of the G? That was the radius of the Earth. As we go above the surface of the Earth, student, what answer you are giving? Value of G, the acceleration due to gravity. As we go above the Earth's surface decreases, what will happen to the value of G, students? G, what we said, acceleration due to gravity, students. Decreases as we go to the center of the Earth is the correct answer. What will happen? Because it is inversely proportional to radius. So next question, student. Next question. The ball is thrown up, the value of G will be?
Sir, it will be negative, C part.
Okay. All right. The ball is going against the gravity, student. So the G will be negative. When it is falling, then G is positive. Acceleration, and this is decreasing. Negative acceleration, student. Negative, that is the correct answer. This answer is correct, students. Next question on the screen, student. The gravitational force causes. Gravitational force causes, students.
Sir, D part, both A and B. Tides,
motion of the moon, none of them, both A and B. Okay. Because of the gravitation, you see the tides in the sea, student. And motion of the moon is also due to the gravitational force, student, which exerts a centripetal force on the moon. That's what we said. So this is the correct answer has been given by the students. All right, you are getting one full mark for that, students. The next question is coming on the screen, student. The mass of the body on moon is 40 kg. What is the weight on the earth, students?
Sir, it is B part, 392 N.
Mass is 40 kg. So, and the weight on the earth. W, what is that? 390, 40 into 9.8. All right, how much it is coming? 392 newtons.
Yes, sir.
All right, that is the correct answer. Newtons, 392, student. Okay. Next question on the screen for you, student. Newton's law of gravitation applies to. Newton's law of gravitation applies to small bodies only. Plants only, all bodies, for solar system.
Sir, C part, all bodies irrespective of their size.
That is the correct answer. Newton's law of gravitation is applicable to each and every body, student. Whether small or big, everywhere it applies. And this answer gets you one full mark, students. Next question is coming on the screen, students. The gravitational force between two objects is F. If masses of both the objects are halved without altering the distance between them, the gravitational force will become F by 4, F by 2, F 2, F, students.
So A part, F by 4.
All right. What is the formula for the gravitational? G, M1, M2 by D the square. So what you are changing, masses of both the objects are halved, then what will happen? F1. F2 will be G, M1 by 2, M2 by 2, and D square is the same. So this is 1 by 4 of F1, students. F by 4 is the correct answer. Correct answer has been given by the students. Very fast answers are coming. Okay. The earth attracts the moon with a gravitational force of 1020 newton. The moon attracts the earth with a gravitational force of. Gravitational force of.
Sir, C part, greater than 10 power 20 newton.
Okay. Earth attracts the moon with a gravitational force of this. The moon attracts the earth with a gravitational force of greater than 10 power 20 newton students. This is 10 power 20. ठीक है, ओके, दैट आंसर इज करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन द स्क्रीन स्टूडेंट. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू बॉडी बिकम्स 6 टाइम्स मोर देन द यूजुअल डिस्टेंस, द फोर्स बिकम्स.
सर इट विल बी डी पार्ट 1/36 टाइम्स.
ऑल राइट, द फोर्स इज गिवन बाय जी एम एम वन एम टू divided by d the square. So it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. So 6 the square will be how much? 36. So f2 will become 1/36 of f1 student. This is the correct answer. Correct answer has been given. So till now your score stands at 10 out of 10 students. Very good answers have been given. Next question is coming, student. Two objects of different masses falling freely near the surface of moon would have same velocities at an instant, different acceleration, experience force of same magnitude, undergo a change in their inertia, students.
So A part have same velocities at an instant.
All right. So it doesn't depend on the mass, student. You have seen experiment was done on Earth also. Two objects of different masses were thrown from the same height, and they would reach the ground at the same time unless the force of friction or force of resistance due to air was there. This is the correct answer, students. You are getting one full mark for this correct answer. Next question is coming on the screen, student. That is question number 2, student. The value of acceleration due to gravity is same on the equator and poles, is the least on poles, is least on equator, increases from pole to equator, students.
Sir, it is C part, is least on equator.
All right, that is the correct answer. The G is determined by which formula, student? Mass and radius, student, R. So when R will increase, G will decrease, and Earth, you know, bulges out, and the distance is more at the equator for the Earth, which you have seen the Earth, student. So this R is bigger. This is small R. This R is bigger than R, students. So this is the center of the Earth. Yes, that is the correct answer. Is least at the equator. Is least at the equator. Further, students, next question. The gravitational force between the two objects. The gravitational force between the two objects, students, is F. If masses of the two both objects are half without changing the distance, then the gravitational force will be.
We sir, already, A part.
Sir, F by 4.
We already answered that question in that. Okay. This is the same question, student. More questions on this. All right. Next question is coming, students. The next question is, a boy is whirling a stone tied to a string in a horizontal circular path. If the string breaks, the stone will continue to move in the circular path, will move in a straight line towards the center of the circular path, will move along a straight line tangential to the circular path, will move along a straight line perpendicular to the circular path from the boy, students.
The C part will move along a straight line tangential to the circular path.
That is the correct answer. Absolutely right answer has been given by Vidhi, that it will move along a straight line in the tangential path. You already have seen that what we are trying to say, student. So if it is like this, what happens? If it is released, it will go follow a tangential path, student. Okay, this was the center of this swing world. Question number 5 on the screen, students. An object is put one by one in 3 liquids having different densities. An object is put one in 3 liquids. There are 3 liquids of different densities in which the same object is put. The object floats with 1 by 9, 2 by 11 and 3 by 7 parts of their volume outside the liquid. These are outside the liquid, students. The densities will be D1 greater than D2, D1 greater than D2 less than what is the order of the density, students, here?
Sir, it will be D part. D1 is smaller than D2 and D2 is smaller than D3.
This much 1 by 9 is in outside. 1 by 9 is outside. And 2 by 11 is outside. How much is this? 0.1? This is how much? This is larger, 2 by 11. And 3 by 7, which is this value is larger than this, value is larger than this. So if D1, D2 are the densities of liquids, you have 3 liquids, liquid 1, liquid 2, liquid 3, density D1, D2, D3. Therefore, what is the object outside, maximum outside is where? Maximum outside is which value? 1 by 9. So that value, that should have the lowest density, students. That is the correct answer. D1 is less than D2 is less than D3. All right. Okay. Next question is coming, students. In the relation F is equal to G M by D square, the quantity G depends on, the G depends on this formula, student. The quantity G depends on the value of G at the place of observation is used only when Earth is one of the two masses is greatest at the surface of the Earth, is universal constant of nature.
Sir, D part is universal constant of nature.
Yes, this is the correct answer. It is the universal constant of the nature. G value doesn't depend on anything. We have already told you when this is one, this is one, this is one. That is what G is. F is equal to G, M is 1, D is 1. So it does not depend on any of these, students. It is a universal constant, universal constant. If I use the SI units, okay. Correct answer, correct answer. Next question is on the screen, student. The law of gravitation, the law of gravitation gives the gravitational force between earth and point mass, earth and sun, any two bodies, two charged bodies only. What is the correct answer, student?
Sir, it is C part, any two bodies having some mass.
Okay, that is the correct answer given by Anya. Your answer is absolutely right. It doesn't, any two bodies which have the same mass, so the force is product of the mass is inversely proportional to the distance between the object, student. These are the two objects, M and D is the distance. Then you know F is equal to G M by D the square. Okay, that is the correct answer. The law of gravitation gives the gravitational force is between any two bodies, any bodies of any mass, no problem. Next question on the screen, student. The value of quantity G in the law of gravitation depends on mass, radius, both mass and radius independent of mass and radius, students.
So D part is independent of mass and radius of
this. Is a very important question, has been asked many times in repeatedly is being asked. F is equal to G when these are unity, students. Therefore, it is independent of mass and radius of the earth. Very important. This has been asked many times in different paper, student. Question is asked many times. Important question. Next question is coming on the screen, student. Two particles are placed at some distance. If the mass of each of the two particles is doubled, keeping the distance unchanged, the value of gravitational force will be 1/4, 4, 1/2 unchanged.
Sir, it will be B part, 4 times.
B is the correct answer. You can see here the formula we have already given. If mass of each of the two particles is doubled, this is my F1. F2 is G2 times, and this is 2 times, student, D the square, then it will be 4 times of F1. Okay, 4 times is the correct answer. Answer is absolutely right, given by Anya. You get one full mark for that, students. Next question is coming on the screen, students. Gravity, chapter gravity. Very, very important chapter, very, very important topic. The atmosphere is held to the earth by gravity, wind, clouds, earth's magnetic field, students.
Sir, A part, gravity.
A is the correct answer, gravity. If there was no gravity, there will be no atmosphere and there will be no life then. It's all over. The whole atmosphere will fly away, students. The right amount of gravity is there to keep it. 2000, how much kilometer of atmosphere is there on the earth, student? You know about it. Is the correct answer. Vidhi, your answer is absolutely right. And we move to the next question. You are beating the clock, students. Timer is on, but you are able to answer in more than before 1 minute. Good attempts by the students. Next question. Force of attraction between two unit point masses separated by unit distance is called. Question number 11, student. Force of attraction between two unit point masses separated by a unit point is called. Gravitational potential, acceleration due to gravity, gravitational field, universal gravitational constant.
Sir, D part, universal gravitational constant.
I said this is very important. A question is coming again and again on G. Again and again, we are saying unit point masses, M is 1, and D is 1, then F becomes equal to G. That is the correct answer. I am saying this question is very important, student. So many times they are asking in papers. Okay, So you understand that certain questions are repeated in different way. They are important for students in different exam. They will appear. Next question is coming, students. The weight of an object at the center of Earth radius r is 0 infinite r times the weight of the surface of the Earth, 1 by r times the weight at the surface of the Earth.
Sir, A part 0.
All right, that is the correct answer. So, we have already told you that if the Earth attraction depends on the radius of the Earth, what will happen here? The weight will become zero, students. That is the correct answer. Okay, all right. We move further, students. An object weighs 10 Newton in air. When immersed fully in water, it weighs only 8 Newton. The weight of the liquid displaced by the object will be, student. What will be the weight of the liquid displaced?
It will be 2 Newton.
Yes. Object was 10 Newton. And when immersed in water, it weighs only 8 Newton. So, the weight of the liquid displaced is equal to weight of liquid displaced is equal to decrease in weight, loss in weight. What was that law? Which principle is this?
Flotation.
Archimedes principle. What do you tell about Archimedes principle, students? Next question is coming on the screen, students. A girl stands on a box having 60 centimeter length, 40 centimeter breadth, and 20 centimeter width in three ways. Box length is how much? 60 centimeter, 40, and 40, and width how much? How much is in 20 centimeter? In which of the following cases pressure exerted by the box will be maximum?
Sir, it is B part. Maximum when breadth and width form the base.
So, what is the pressure? Is force per unit area? When the area is minimum? 20 into 40. Is how much? 800 centimeter square. And 60 into 40 is how much? 2400. And 60 into 20 will be how much? 1200. So what will be the minimum area? Only 20 into 40, huh? What is that? Which part you have answered? Breadth and?
Sir, B part. Maximum when breadth and width form the base.
Okay. B part is the correct answer. The area is minimum in B part. Okay. Next question, students. An apple falls from a tree because of gravitational attraction between the Earth and apple. If F1 is the magnitude of force exerted by Earth on the apple and F2 is the magnitude of force exerted by apple on the Earth, then F1 is much larger than F2, F2 is much larger than F1, F1 is greater, F1, F12 are equal. Which is the correct answer, students?
Sir, D part.
Okay, forces, equal and opposite forces will be exerted. That is the correct answer, student. But different accelerations are produced because the masses are different. Forces will be same. Forces are same, but masses are different, therefore accelerations will be different. So that is the reason apple will experience larger acceleration, and that's why apple falls on the earth and earth is not falling on the apple. Clear? All right, you understood that point. Next question, acceleration due to gravity on earth depends on mass of the body, mass of the earth, shape and size of the body, volume of the body. Which factor acceleration depends on?
The B part, mass of the earth.
Mass of the earth. What was the formula? G equal to G m by r square. So what is it? It depends on the mass of the earth. There is no body, mass of the body, and nothing is involved. This body is not involved. Not involved anywhere. That is the correct answer. Next question, students. When a mango falls from mango tree, then only earth attracts the mango, only mango attracts the earth. Both mango and earth attracts each other. Both mango and earth repel each other. What is the correct answer?
Sir, it is C part. Both the mango and the earth attract
each other. That is the correct answer. There is equal and opposite force, students, but acceleration produced are different because the masses are different. That is the correct answer. Next question on the screen, students. When a ship floats in sea water, the weight of the water displaced is greater than the weight of the ship. The weight of water displaced is less than the weight of the ship. The weight of water is equal to the weight of the ship. It displaces no water.
So C part, the weight of water displaced is equal to the weight of the ship.
That is the correct answer. Law of flotation, Arshmiran, we have told you that is the reason ship is floating on water, students. And it is not sinking, it is floating, student. Correct answer. Next question is coming, student. Question 19. The SI unit of pressure is Newton meter square, Newton per meter, Newton per meter square, Newton square. Which is the correct answer?
So C part, Newton per meter square.
C is the correct answer. Force per unit area, Newton meter square. That is the correct answer, student. One full mark for that. Next question on the screen. If gravitational attraction of Earth suddenly disappears, which of the following statement will be true, students? The weight of the body will become zero, but mass will remain same. Weight of the body will remain same, mass will become zero. Both mass and weight become zero. Neither mass nor weight become zero. What is the correct answer, students?
So A part, the weight of the body will become zero, but the mass will remain same.
That is the correct answer. Absolutely right answer, student. You are getting one full mark, student. Therefore, student, you are the total marks obtained in the revision lecture and quiz, student, 30 out of 30, and you are getting 100% marks, students. Marks obtained 100%, full marks. Therefore, it's a great performance once again. You have done very good. So very, very good, students. Great, great, great result. All question answered correctly by the students. So congratulations to you, students. And keep it up. So we are satisfied. Lot of appreciation for the students. These are motivational quizzes. They will motivate you to work more, more and learn more and more students. So by these questions, we have learned also more. I have also learned more from you by providing such quizzes, such question answer. The learning is a two-way process. You also teach me, I also teach you students. Therefore, my best wishes, and then I will meet you in my next class, students. Keep on sharing our videos with your friends. They are very important questions are being discussed. Help the students, share them, subscribe our videos, our channel. Okay, bye-bye. I'll see you in my next class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.